guys, welcome back to Two Guy Nails Life on Monday. How y'all doing today? We're gonna come back to Monday with another summer nail art. And this is some of the product that we're gonna use today. So, we're gonna do some blue nail for anyone who are planning or plan to do beach nail. So this is what we're gonna do today. So this is the color I'm gonna use today. How do you say it?
Cerulean.
Cerulean. So this is the color we're gonna use today, along with some gel polish from Two Guys. So we're gonna do some nail art today using this beautiful color from Two Guys. So stay tuned for that.
Wow, we're finally breaking into gel color.
I know, I think we've been doing a lot of abstract nails, so now today we're doing some painting.
Yay, we're back to the nail art again, guys. You guys who look forward to that, who enjoy those content, we're back again with those.
So we kind of get a mix up on the designs, so making sure that we always have something in mind, some idea for upcoming trip or with your client. I hope these gonna be helpful. So I already wrapped her nails, so now we're gonna remove it. You see how it already like loose enough for me, and I'm gonna push it off. With Two Guy powder, it's so easy to remove. You guys see that? This is one way to keep the nail healthy and the client can enjoy them for a long time without worrying. Goodbye, this set. This set color was one of my favorite one.
It's a great color combo. If you guys missed that live, be sure to go back and rewatch it.
Yep.
Let's see what we did for this design, cut is pretty crazy and pretty amazing.
Next, I'm gonna chain my bead to this one, and then I'm gonna also use the Zebra sanding band from Two Guys. You know that these one are my favorite, so just insert in, press it in, I'm good to go. Can I see your?
We're starting fresh again, you guys. For the next greatest art piece there is.
Let me know if you guys would like to do a fill or you refer a new set. I'm normally a new set kind of gal, so for me, just like removing and giving a fresh look, it's just something that it make me sure that the nail is healthy, everything is ready, I don't have any cracking, lifting under. And it's just a good start, since normally the client goes like 3 weeks plus for their service. So for me, having a fresh nail set, it's just reassuring for me that everything is good and I'm having a fresh start.
It's like getting maintenance for your electronic or something, making sure everything is good underneath.
And as you all know, the Gree SL No Seekers wet tip is always my favorite one. So we're gonna glue it on. Dust some of the dust off. One of my things that I like is flipping the hand over to glue the new tip. This is just my personal, but I quite enjoy it, especially when you are doing longer nail, just because you make sure that all the nail is in one direction. Because sometimes, I mean, it's always good to see from your client's perspective, so everything is nice and secure and straight. But I saw a lot of whoever watching the live and purchased the tip and enjoying it. I'm so glad that you got it and using it with me.
You're able to take part in this amazing product.
Yeah. Also, it's just the part that I'm recommending something and then
somebody actually listened to.
Somebody actually used it and think it helpful. That's very encouraging.
We love these tip guys.
You know that I'm living with the tips. And this year, I mean, a lot of my clients change from coffin to square. The people who wear shorter, they refer to almond. And that's more like a constantly the two shape that I've been doing. Well, here and there, I still have some kind of blue coffin. But I would say square have been very, very popular. And having these sway and no seeker tips is allowed you to do a lot of things. And I mean a lot.
These also come in the 2XL size if you don't use the boy, like the really long legs. Yeah, 2XL, 3XL in square and coffin. There's also refill available for 2XL at the moment. 2XL square. And I love that these tips are clear. Whenever you do like ombre or something, you can really see the color underneath. It's so fun. Now, if you like any of the product we're using in today's live, be sure to go to the website, add it to your cart, and use JJ code. Our code is capital J10 for 10% off your order. Like any of this product, go check it out, okay?
I'm gonna file the sidewall a little bit because sometimes I normally go a slight tad bigger than the actual side to make sure that it doesn't pinch out the natural nail. So if you have anything extra, it's only good to file the sidewall a little bit. To make sure that you actually got what you wanted. Then next, I'm going to use the tip to blend the natural nail. Like that. Now we're going to get them a dust off. Repair my monomer for today. So I'm gonna use Alice monomer neutralizer. I would say I'll do a couple drops. Three. I think you recommend before five, but since I still have some monomer left, so I'm just at about 3 drops. Also, my favorite premium EMA monomer from Two Guy is low to medium setting, perfect for beginners.
I mean, it works so good with Tugai powder.
And by the way, my brush is Kolinsky, a pure Kolinsky from Tugai, and it's size 14. So I've been saying it a lot, my brush looked pretty bad because of the condition of it, but this is how it looks in last fall, still in shape. And once again, my brush is not pinched.
The shape that you usually, it just naturally comes to that shape. Very high quality. It's available in sizes 12, 14, 16, and 18 at the moment. It also comes in gold and pink, whichever one you prefer. Hello everyone that just joined us today. We're doing summer, another summer set meal. If you'd like to get some ideas, some tutorial, see some demonstration and use of our product, please join us for today's live.
So before I start up my application, I'm going to give you the acid-free primer from Tugai. This is going to help with max bonding of the product to the nails. Also, this is acid-free, so it's not going to be sensitive for the nails. And also for people who are using the gloves, you can still use this as a primer. So the color I'm using today is A57 and
Cerulean.
Cerulean.
I hope I said that right. It's like, I don't remember the word.
Okay, we're gonna try. People are gonna let us know.
Such a beautiful color.
I know. I think it's gorgeous.
Once again, the powder goes on buttery smooth. Amazing quality of the powder is very consistent in all of Tugai's products.
And you see how the powder just slows in definitely to more? And I mainly work on the sidewall of the nail instead of the middle. It's like when I kind of let it flow. For people who work on a customer, you actually can tilt the nail back and let the gravity help you. But sitting in the live, I want you guys able to see this. So I'm just normally holding it this way.
Thank you, Jalen, for the live. Guys, remember to give us a lot of like, give us a comment, let us know how we're doing. Share this video, okay? Let all your nail tech or your friend, let everybody know about today's like. Let's see more of you guys watching us. If you have any questions about Tugai's product, we love to answer them on the site. We also like to share tips and experience from one nail tech to another.
With me doing the live, it's just an experience, and you are just like a partner of us that we are on the same boat and sharing this moment together. Hopefully everyone have fun with it, or maybe you pick up some tips, learn something new, or even if a mistake, you guys would learn from that mistake and it won't happen to you guys while you guys working on a client. So, I mean, it's just a fun moment.
I mean, it'd be great for you to make a friend in the comment section and stuff.
Yeah.
As always, you learn from each other.
The brush I'm using is size 14 in my unpinch, and it's on the pink version. So for these finger, I'm gonna do an ombre, but in just leave the tip right here clear. You want to go and clear it out? Sorry guys, we didn't clear some noise in the background. Do you guys have a good Monday so far? Summer.
Hopefully. Oh my god, next sweater is like going back and forth between, I don't know, every season. It just hail last week too. That's crazy, y'all.
I can never forget that day. Ever.
Out of nowhere though. Like, usually it's like a lot of morning before that happens.
So far away doing the same thing. Last week it just hail and snow and everything is just like insane. So for this part, instead of leaving it clear, I didn't want to do it. So I'm gonna use two guys. Alcohol ink and I'm gonna add a few drops of it to the monomer. What it is when you work with clear powder, it kind of tints in the powder.
Do you guys see that? It's even showing on camera. It looks so cool.
So I'm gonna mix it up. And then I'm gonna go ahead and use my clear powder. Once again, we are using crystal clear, which is number one. From two guy nails.
Yes, it is the number one.
So I'm gonna slightly tap it. Making sure that you work with small beads so that way you can control any bubble, anything that you don't want into it.
I really love when you do that application. This powder bond is so like smooth, jelly-like.
done with the application?
Yeah, because she's only like a little bit more like, to go, and that's it. And she's even doing like an online stage, not just regular application. Why is the color from the monitor? The color is using from the two guys.
Yep, so what I did, I mixed our alcohol ink number 5, the color blue, and I add a few drops into my monomer, and I mix it up, and I dip it into clear powder for the application. So that way it's gonna give me some jelly looking. Maybe we should wait until Ariel or the Ariel movie is coming out.
When is that even gonna come out? It's been like advertised and promoted like all over. It's been a while. But this would be perfect. Are you gonna try to do a realistic Ariel?
Maybe. Every time it's shark week, she all over the nail with shark.
Good, you know that shark week. The first time I ever heard about that is her client. Look at that, guys. You see this? So beautiful. And it's just from the color of the hot ink inside. Come on. It tinted the crystal clear into this color. It's almost like a perfect match for this acrylic cerulean.
I'm gonna go ahead and go in with some regular normal monomer to add some thickness.
You can see today we took a break away from the neon bright acrylic colors, and we're going into more of the peachy vibe.
A little softer. I would say the design today is still colorful, but it just a little toned down from the past week that we've been doing with on a funky looking one. And I use the word funky because I seriously mean it quite good.
It glow. When I mean it glow. It really glow in the light. Of course, JJ is already gonna go extra mile on the design. So
Me, when I want to do a design, it's more like I have a vision. And you guys are part of this journey with me to make my vision kind of come true. I know sometimes I make mistakes when I'm not 100% like what I want, but I try. So this is what we got so far.
Can you guys all see this? It's almost a little bit of translucent with the crystal clear ombre right there. I can tell. But it do be pretty.
I think I love how
it kind of blended in together. Like
I know.
The color, it's just kind of perfect in that you put the right amount of alcohol in to make this color. Wow, guys. Be sure to try out this technique with the other color too. Maybe there's a different combo that you can make. I would love to see that. So if you guys ever create any of our new tutorial, be sure to tag us. Let us know how you did. If you like the design, if you actually find the tutorial helpful, give us a like if you think it's helpful, and be sure to share to all your friends, your tech. Let them know. What are we doing next?
Fouling.
Which is the best part.
Everyone not so favorite.
I know, we tend to everybody just leave us at this point. But the best and most important part of them all, the shaping.
For anyone who wonder what hand file I'm using, is a 80 grit from Two Guys, and it's one of the premium hand file, right?
Yeah, it's a washable type. So if you have those, if you're one of those people that would like to, let's say, save the environment a little bit on those ways and such, and would like to keep a specific file for each of your clients, this would be a great option, a great alternative to the regular file. It's super sturdy, high quality, so even after you use it for that client and you like to save it again for them next time, just wash it, clean it a little bit, so clean it normal how you clean other tools, I guess, and dry it, and it'll be good as new. Remember, guys, these are washable, but at the same time, you can throw it away. Don't use it for the same
time. How do I want the monomer run over my brush? Remember, keep to that.
Look how nice brush.
I'm not sure what do you mean when it's wet. Like, your beak is too wet, or... Can you tell me a little more detail?
It's wet when I hold it. Your brush, like your whole brush itself, and the handle.
If you're too wet when you hold it, you can dab it on the paper a little bit before you start your application, or also try to take less monomer. You might take in too much of monomer. By practicing, pick up the bead, so you can just get used to the ratio of the powder in the monomer.
Depending on on what kind of powder you use too.
Mm-hmm.
And monomer. You would have to work with it a little bit.
From what I think, you probably take too much monomer. So I would suggest you get one of those practice and just practice picking up the beads. Just practice so you can get used to the ratio between the monomer and the powder.
Welcome back. Love that blue. Thank you. Very pretty.
I hope it answered your question. But if you do try it, let me know next time how did you do.
Yeah, I gave my monomer to try, so I had to get more monomer to make it move easier.
Instead of getting more monomer because your bead is too dry, try to do small bead. Because if you already have a problem with controlling, don't add it more because it's going to be harder for you to work with. So I recommend do a smaller bead. And also practice on shorter nails. Also, when you wet your brush, take whatever powder you can. You don't take too much powder, then you add a monomer. That is just way too many things at once. So I recommend just do small beads and it will be easier to control. There's nothing wrong with how many beads it takes you as long as the outcome of it.
Alright. A little go a long way. We said that a lot of these lives we do.
I'm sorry to say this, but we don't do MMA. The monomer I'm using is straight from the manufacturer, and we only do EMA. Especially, I do work in tested, and for the TDLR, which is tested license regulation, we don't do MMA, even with mixing, specifically for me. That's why I become two guy ambassador because of their product. I understand that sometimes some other people advise you to mix MMA in so help with control the color powder, but
using two guys product.
Yeah, if you're using two guys product, especially monomer and powder, is made to work with, together, and also when it turns up soap off and the health of the nail, it's just much better. And also for your own health, because once again, I always say this is and not mean anything to bashing about your what technique you're using, but we are nail tech, we're not chemists. I'm just not spending my time on mixing stuff. And I want to focus more what I can with my application perfection, shaping an application more than doing that. And that's why it's hard to find a market adjusted product that you can
rely on
and it allow you to reach out or go further.
Because with mixing it, you would have to take time, measure out the ratio and such. You would like to find a product that you can skip that whole step and not worry about the ratio of how it's going to come out each time.
It's nice to meet you on this live, and I hope you at least try two guy product one. We do have monomer in a AL bottle, so it won't be too much for you to buy the whole thing when you're not sure how you're gonna do with it. And just buy one or two color and kind of use them together.
Yeah, try it out.
you don't need to buy too much if you're not sure what happening is, but just buy a small bottle and one or two colors. You can even just get one. Maybe get a nude. Send nude, you can get a good use of it no matter what. And then try to practice with it. At first, try to do learn or practice pick up the bead. So you're gonna use to what is the ratio between the monomer and the powder. And then secondly, do with small shorter nails so you can use the application and know that ratio and master your control. And then by the time you're comfortable with all of that, you can increase the length.
As we said before, you have to work with it a little bit to know the product, but we try to keep the product very consistent, or at least the company's goal is to do that. So you wouldn't get one that is super runny or something, and one that is, the color doesn't come out too great.
But the thing is, two-guy monomer and powder is very beginner-friendly. If you're a well-known artist or a beginner, it should be easy for you to work with. By the way, if you decide to get something, don't forget to use the code JJ10. Letter J, number 10. I know it's not much, but at least it's 10%. So now we're going to use the drill to go over the cuticle.
Perfect right now. Do you guys like this? I love the color today.
Right? It's so cute.
I say that every time. I love every color that you do, because every time you do it, it fits into a theme.
That's why sometimes I got a client ask me, is the color ugly? And I'm like, no, the color is not ugly. It depends on how you use it, how you style them, how you dress them. Because I normally say, if you like me, I can be your best nail tech. But if you don't like me, then I'll become your worst nail tech. So, they're not really an ugly color. It depends on how you style them.
Yeah, and then I find that different. You know, like you guys notice out there on the social media and stuff, each nail tech has a specific style or a unique design that they do. They can do like other people design too, or like, you know, make their own unique one, but everyone have a style, and if you're into that style, Are you into that kind of thing? Then that's a perfect outfit.
Okay.
Almost there with the filing guy.
When you file wear nail, make sure you file the side of the nail well. Just because when we add the tip, we add it to the nail, especially right here. But when you add the powder on top, you increase the volume. So that way it becomes a little wider. So in order to keep the shape nice and crisp, make sure you file your side nice and well. And not just this way, also under here, same way on this side.
The file is very sturdy, to help you with that.
As you guys can see, that I actually hand file more than using the e-file, because I feel like hand file are very, very important.
It's also key to keeping that very straight edge. It might be harder to do that on the file. What do you think?
Place now. You're probably late today, girl.
I think you were already on the TikTok live earlier.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. And you keep on back and forth between the two.
Oh.
She should be here.
She's quiet today.
Okay, she missed us. Thank you. you're having a wonderful day.
I sure do. Thank you.
I hope you also have a wonderful Monday. Can't wait to see the finish of me too. I still don't know what she's doing today. Of course, it's going to be something extra. So what do you guys think it is? What do you guys think the design is for this meal? It's blue. And Betsy Drew. Are you doing a SeaWorld theme?
More likely.
More likely, she said. Isn't that so cute? You do like a spring butterfly look on me too. I would love that. I think you did something like that for me a long time ago.
Did I?
Yeah. Oh, I don't remember. You did like an ombre.
Come to the nail art, guys. Are you guys excited? I feel like this one is on the way. Everyone's favorite part. So, I'm going to use the Two Guys Primo Line Art Show. I'm going to use some yellow, some blue, and these are the gel polish from Two Guys. They either the Supreme Line Gel or the regular gel polish from Two Guys.
If you got the mystery package back in during winter, break out those liners and start using them for this design.
So I need some white. Color is always
super pigmented in all of our gel liner or gel polish. It's great for doing art design like this and for the baby gel now. I love people that does.
My palette for some of the color that I'm using. One again, the color are from Two Guys. So I got my nails right here. So, my favorite color is pink, so I'm going to start out with the pink. And by doing this, I hope you guys can recognize what these dyes is.
For those that are on TikTok, you can't see very, very well. You're welcome to
gotta tell what he's gonna be.
This is look familiar to him.
Yep.
Does anyone recognize what his eye will be?
A blob.
It's summer.
I love bright colors. These two go so well together. Can you guys see it? We've got two wiggly flowers down.
One again, the gel polish is two-sided gel polish, and the brushes I'm using is the liner brush.
Yes, y'all, get your liner brush now. It's great for nail art and great for the design like these. I think you got it. That's totally a SpongeBob flower. Wait, what is that? Is it a flower or jellyfish? No,
I think it had a name.
Is it jellyfish? I did the same cheek. Oh my god, I need to see that. Oh, that's a squirrel name.
Well, you never remember.
I know, SpongeBob, Patrick, Jerry, that's enough, right? For sure. Oh my god, I'm already loving it. I don't barely see it. Just the idea of you doing that, I can picture it in my head.
It does have a name though.
Do you think I know what that was called? The flower thing?
I remember it had a name. I actually don't remember what it is.
You're beautiful. Thank you, thank you.
So flask cure them in between so the polish can be stay in place and they won't move.
SpongeBob is very summer then. Check it out. Bright, bright color. Yes, what do you use to clean your brushes with?
This is all.
Remember, yeah, if you want to keep your brush looking nice and in shape and great for long use, be sure to clean your brushes. cute. I love the color. Now you can really tell it's summer. Yeah, you can do any more of these SpongeBob name packages, okay? Sometimes you need more version of these.
Because we're doing it together.
Right. I love the interaction we have with everyone. Something new each time.
I remember last week when
she said, I wish you guys would do it more often. Like every day or every other day.
Live painting until I have two guys gel powder. The fact that it's gel polished but it's still pigmented enough for me to paint, that is a bonus.
Because I'm always tired of, you know, having art gel and then regular gel, and just for me it's a bit much. And by having the gel polish, I can explore my creativity. It's just, I'm so happy with it.
Without the redundancy of doing over and over and over, it's kind of ruined the creative aspect of it.
It's glowing.
person looking for a gel polish that you can paint, do design, nail art with, definitely check out Two Guy Gel Polish.
It's very multi-use.
You get your money worth it.
Because you can use them to do French, you can use them to do more detail artwork. What else have you done?
I don't remember.
Way too many guys. What is the dark blue? Do you mean the dark blue as in the painting file she just did? Or the acrylic is that?
If you're asking about the gel polish, it's number 856, Dutch Iris Blue Magic. And this is the color.
I love that blue. Even in the powder, it's so vibrant.
You're welcome.
Okay, I just googled what that lovely thing is called. And it's called the flower cloud. Here in the background. I would never knew the name of the flower cloud. They're just like floating in the sky, well, the sky being the sea.
It looks so cute, like so fun.
Definitely Tiki Beach vibe.
So now I'm going to go in with the white gel polish to create some bubble.
Hair bubble.
You can make the one.
That's it for easy to make. It's a circle and then highlight. I'm going to try it one more time. Take two. Well, that's a very teeny tiny bubble. Yay! How did it done?
She's like barely drawing it with the very, very tip of her liner brush. However, the gel is super pigmented to the point that you can like still see it showing up pretty bright.
Those of you on
TikTok, I'll show you just a minute.
Aww, it's so cute.
Can you see it? Pretty teeny tiny bubble.
Thank you
for the follow. And be sure to follow us. Turn on your notification because we go live every Monday, usually at 8 p.m. Central Time. You can catch us almost every week here. We'll do a new design to fit into the season, consider holiday, whatever you guys suggest, whatever you guys think we should do next. Be sure to give us a lot of likes.
I mean, we didn't mention that, but the blue kind of go with Memorial Day.
Right, that is coming up. That's why I went to IKEA the other day and it just like, oh, black color. That was
fast way.
If you opt this for nothing to be like a reddish, it would be perfect. So cute, y'all. She probably saved the best for last guy. Stay tuned. And if you guys miss any part of the beginning of our life, be sure to just follow us and then we'll be reposting the slides after. You can also check out our previous video of the tutorial, either this season, last season, Valentine, whichever.
Next time you get some green gloss coat to pop coat. It looks so fun.
I think it's better once you put off the gloss and you can actually see the ombre showing up.
Can I have the charger, please? Thank you. Going to the beach. Two guy will be at the Premiere Orlando in June. So if you happen to be at the Premiere Orlando, stop by to see us. Totally forgot about that. What is our booth number? Do you know?
2229. Be sure to check us out. Save the day. We love to see you guys there. If anyone is coming,
yes. Let
us know. Stop by. We want to meet you. We want to talk to you. To finally put a name to a face.
look for the two eyes logo. And that's coming up in about, let's see, 2 weeks? 2.5 weeks? It's coming up very close, beginning of June. It's close to 2 weeks. Come see us at the Premiere Orlando. You can get more detail on our booth number, and I can come up to that show too on our social media page and our web page too, which would be like front and center. She found it, she's been using it for like every life. Use a thing, and when I found it, I'm like, I have it all this time, and I never.
But you have the putter. Are you like using it every day?
I'm like crazy about it.
Anything.
I'm a person when I like the song, I listen it over and over and over until I'm sick of it. I'm like. A water drop, but under my nail. Not really. Oh my god!
Yo.
Let me see.
They're so cute.
I like it. That's so cool. Look at this guy. Do you love it or do you love it? You guys see that?
I have to recreate this and I'll send you a tag.
Yes!
New course, SpongeBob! SpongeBob inspired.
So look.
Love this.
That's so fun.
Just a neat detail. See, you guys can all elevate your nail design just a little bit extra technique.
It's so fun! I love the color.
It almost looks like it's wet. Like, literally, my nails are wet.
you number 42, Economy Lanio. Wow. Are you?
I am. Technically speaking, but I feel very close to being a millennial. But technically, it's categorized as Jiffy.
Bye!
Yes. Come back and watch the ending tomorrow. As always, you can come back and replay all of our lives if you miss any part of it.
What is that? You can draw Ariel?
I wish. Are you doing a realistic Ariel? Like you said. It'd be perfect for the movie, though. But wouldn't SpongeBob right now? What about that color? My only guess is Patrick. It has to be Patrick.
Starting to look like a starfish guy. The color will be pretty good. And once again, it's called Millennial, number 42.
Getting it, guys. Got to adjust the process.
I can never tell what you do when you just started. Well, you never go anyway. You look weird. It's always kind of weird.
It's okay. I know what I'm doing.
Trust your nails, that guy.
stress your gut.
I worry about. I just always wonder if I do it, is it gonna turn out like that, or like gonna be completely opposite. But I guess you gotta try to know.
I mean, it's okay to fail as long as you still get up and drive again.
Of course, that is the most important part, the getting up part. We sound like those But it's very true though. It's not matter if you fail, you just try it again. No harm done when you try it again.
Brightest pain that I ever seen.
But it looked like he about to go to the beach.
Like a swim box.
I mean, that's all I'm thinking. Where? That doesn't make it flashy.
Remember to drive the polish in between so you can flash cure it and keep going.
Keep your design, stay ready, don't mess with the next layer.
Can you guys tell who he is?
I think we all know at this point who he is. Who's the star of the show? No pun intended. So with his pants, it's definitely a showstopper.
Can be very squishy. I don't think I ever actually seen a real starfish. Definitely a starfish.
Why do you say that?
Go to the dot.
Wait, is Rose not gonna touch the dot?
I get that how you breathe.
Really? I don't know. I don't think the whole body is freckle.
Definitely.
Do you see the black?
I was right here. Looks like you just picked it up.
So jumpy.
What I'm saying, he looks kind of squishy. Like a sea cucumber, rather than a sea
So cute.
Okay.
What do you guys think? We got Mr. Patrick the Starfish.
Can you put your hand like this?
That's so cute, guys. So this is the final nail look for today. And how water affects the flower.
A bit of see-through moment.
Yep.
And then you are.
Yep.
Let me give you some cuticle oil.
This is so cute.
Thank you for watching, guys. We see y'all.